Hello guys, today we are going to talk about op amps, which are called also operational amplifiers. And op amps are nothing but active electronic components which take in two inputs. As you can see, this is the op amp. It has an inverting input and a non-inverting input, and the op amp is called active electronic component because it also has a secondary power source. So as you can see here, like it has a plus V supply and plus minus V supply, which is an external power source. And op amp is primarily used for a lot of things actually. As you can see here, it's used for amplifying your outputs, and it's also used for filters. And for op amps, there are three main things you have to remember. Op amps always try to equalize the voltage at both the terminals, so the V minus and V plus are always equal. So the voltage at this point and the voltage at this point are always equal. And the second thing is that I minus and I plus is equal to zero. So the current at this junction and this junction is always zero, and the resistance between both the terminals is considered to be infinity. And remember, this is in an ideal case, right? And so the way you use op amp for making amplifiers is by selecting a set of resistors and capacitors and making a circuit. So I'm going to give you an example of how to make a circuit for inverting amplifier and how to derive the transfer function for it, right? So the transfer function is also your amplitude of gain for your circuit, right? So usually, as you can see here, if you have a input of V minus and V plus, your output would be minus A times your V plus minus V minus, right? So the A we can figure out based on your requirement. So for example, in the case of inverting amplifier, you can so this is a circuit for the inverting amplifier, and from the Kirchhoff's first law, current law, you know that sum of all the currents at a junction is equal to zero, right? Here you can see that the current at this junction is I1 plus I2, which is equal to I3, and is equal to zero because in the op amp we said that I minus equal to I at the junction is equal to zero, right? So from that we can see that the potential, when we convert it using Ohm's law to Vt minus Vin by Ri plus Vt minus Vout by Rf is equal to zero, you can get the transfer function by just following the steps, and in the end you get minus Rf by Ri for your inverting amplifier, right? So basically what this means is, if you give an input of, for example, 1, your output would be minus Rf by Ri into, you can see it from here, right? And that would be V plus 1. 0 minus 1, which is nothing but minus of Rf by Ri. And if we take the Rf as 2 ohm and Ri as 2 kilo ohm and Ri as 1 kilo ohm, your output would be minus 2, right? So your gain would be minus 2. So if you have a input that's 1 of amplitude 1 your output would be in the opposite direction, and its amplitude would be 2, right?
Yeah. So for this experiment, we are going to use LM348, and its circuit diagram and its chip diagram looks like this. It has 4 op amps in it, and so like to recognize which direction you are using it, we use the notch to identify the direction. Right. Thank you.